The Samsung Galaxy S10 is the first phone from the Galaxy series that supports wireless charging using the Qi standard to other devices. This means that if you run out of battery on another phone or another accessory like headphones that supports wireless charging, you can now use your Galaxy S10 as an emergency power bank. Previously, the only way to charge other devices from your Galaxy phone was to use USB power delivery technology. Let's compare which is faster to use, USB PD or wireless Qi. We'll go ahead and use the Galaxy S10 5G that we picked up in Korea and use that as the power bank, which we will then use to charge the Galaxy S10 Plus and then later the Sony Xperia XZ3, both of which support Qi. To perform the testing, we'll use the GRL PowerSuite Pro application, and here in the third-party tool section, we'll set up tracking for two Android battery monitoring tracks. We've gone ahead and installed the GRL Android battery monitoring application from the Google Play Store on all the phones that we're tracking. So here on port 1, we are tracking the Samsung Galaxy S10 5G, which again is acting as a power source. And on port 2, we are monitoring either the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus or the Sony XZ3. First, let's look at USB power delivery charging. Through USB PD, the Galaxy S10 5G offers only 2.5 watts or 0.5 amps at 5 volts to any USB PD devices connected to it, including in this case the Sony XZ3. After the power delivery contract is completed, the Sony XZ3 accepts the 5 volt contract and pulls the full 0.5 amps or 2.5 watts from the S10 5G. Once receiving the 2.5 watts over USB VBUS, the XZ3 then translates that into an eventual 0.7 watts of battery charging. However, using the GRL PowerSuite Pro, we found that the Galaxy S10 5G actually allowed devices to exceed the 0.5 max current being offered and allowed devices to pull up to 0.9 amps before OCP. This means that from a hardware design standpoint, the Galaxy S10 5G can actually deliver a total of 4.5 watts out of its USB Type-C port through power delivery, although in practice, 2.5 watts is more realistic unless the device is going to exceed the PD contract established. Now, by comparison with Qi wireless charging, we could see that by default, the phone could actually provide up to 5 watts of power at any time. However, in practice, there are a lot of gotchas which cause faster Qi charging to actually stop prematurely. One of the situations that can happen is due to overheating, something which you rarely see in the case of USB power delivery-based charging. When testing the Sony Xperia XZ3, we can see that once the temperature hit around 43 degrees Celsius, the phone decided to stop all Qi charging from the Galaxy S10 5G. Now, when we ran the same set of tests on the Galaxy S10 Plus, we see that once the battery of the Galaxy S10 5G falls below 30%, it also stops Qi charging. Again, with USB power delivery, often you can continue to charge out of a phone even after the battery has gone below 30%. After hitting the 30% battery issue, we then switched over from Qi charging to USB PD charging to continue to drain the Galaxy S10 5G battery. With a full 100% of battery from the S10 5G, through this combination of Qi and USB PD charging, This translated into about a 40% charge from dead battery for the Galaxy S10 Plus. Overall, while Qi provides faster theoretical charging of up to 5 watts, USB PD is slower, but there's a lot less maintenance involved in worrying about overheating or falling below a 30% battery condition.